attending university without knowing the kind of program you are going to do is one of the tragic moments in one's life. Because if you don't know the program or if you don't understand the program you are going to do at the university, you'll complete and you'll not be pleased with the kind of job the program will land you or the program will present to you. So I've decided to carry the burden and then explain university programs, then the career opportunities we have in the various programs, so that we can all understand the programs as well as the job opportunities we have in those programs, so that we will choose the right program in our university careers. So let's look at Bachelor of Science, Computer Science, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. If you're going to Kea University or if you're going to University of Ghana, or if you're going to UCC or any other university of your choice, and if you want to pursue computer science, or if you want to have a particular career or job in the IT, then this is the right place for you to learn from and get to know some of the opportunities you can have after practicing computer science in your university career, in your university period. Okay, so when you go to university to pursue this program, there are lots of courses that you do. It differs, and the way it has been arranged is different from the university, so get to know that. But you'll be doing something like software development, networking, cyber security, database management, management information system or information system management. Yes, it's kind of managerial course, however it is purely IT. Yeah, but it's just interrelated. I hope you understand. You also do much of artificial intelligence, you do distributed systems, you do network security, like I said earlier. You also do mobile application development. You do software engineering, you do software development, analyzation, app analyzation, and other stuff. In fact, you will be going into IT and you will be introduced to how IT is affecting the economy, or is affecting the business world, or is affecting organizations, and how it is being used in various organizations nowadays, or in current or in modern days. So that's what is going to land you or is going to grant you when you pursue this program. And I would like you to go to university that do much of practical work or field work, so that you'll be accustomed to the system before you even complete. Yeah, because completing school without getting a job is one of the unpleasant or repulsive moments in our life. We all believe that after having a particular knowledge and skills, you deserve to practice it, and that can be done in your job or in your career. So let's look at some of the job opportunities you have after pursuing computer science or Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Alright, you can become application analyst, you can become a web designer or website designer. Yes, it can be like you are designing a new website for somebody, or you are creating a new website, or you are updating the old one so that all informations can be found over there. Or if somebody wants to transact or do any business with that organization, they can just log into their website and then start contacting them, and then the business goes on. You can also become a software engineer. You create and you plan and you maintain the software, computer softwares, yes, between organizations or even within organizations. You can also become mobile app developer. If you want to develop mobile apps, you can also do that after pursuing computer science in university. Like I said earlier, don't forget to practice all that you think you are going to do after school, so that you don't lose a single thing. You can also have a knowledge to do coding. Yes, programmer, or let's say coding, that's what most people known to or familiar to. Yes, coding and programming. Yes, you can have a career in that area. You can also become a cyber security analyst, or you can develop a cyber security, or let's say you can protect the organization's information and their staff or their information or their data in the organization. You can also become a management information system manager or manager of information system. Yes, you protect all the information in the organization, and you also keep them in such a good manner that if they want to make decision based on the information in the organization or you've collected from outside the organization, so that they can make decision based on the information you've collected or you've accessed. You can also become a database manager or database administrator. It's a different work, but it's interrelated. Yeah, so you also have all the data recorded and accessible. Yes, easily recorded and accessible, and it's also free of corruption and losses. So database manager also record all the data and make sure that it is free from corruption and losses, and when it is needed you'll be able to access it or you can easily retrieve it. So that's the job of the database manager. You can also become a school teacher or a lecturer or even a high school teacher teaching IT or impacting knowledge in IT, because this world is currently information world. And when I say information world, it's more of IT or more of information technology. So it's all about having knowledge in these areas so that you can cope with how the world is moving, or you can move with how the world is moving. Because if you are not good in IT, in fact, you'll be left behind. You can also establish consultancy firm that you can be guiding people on website design, server security, mobile app application, and other stuff. So there are lots of job opportunities that I can't even talk about all of them here. So having an intention to pursue a degree in ICT is going to land you a lot of job opportunities. So friends, I'll urge you to subscribe to this channel and then hope for more of this educational content videos, so that we can all go for programs that's the best prepare for our future, so that we don't regret attending university. Thank you.